I am Jayaprada from JPSS Malayal Madugu, Ashwapur Mandal. Today we are going to see about excretion, the wastage disposing system. So the wastage disposing system means the waste is disposed. How the waste is disposed? No company can manufacture without any waste. In cell also the waste is produced. The waste is produced due to metabolic activities. Here metabolic activities can be again classified into anabolic and catabolic. So here in anabolic activities, anabolism means building up like photosynthesis. Catabolism means catabolic activity, that is catabolism means breakdown. So here in photosynthesis, building up, in the same way respiration is catabolic. Now we can see that during anabolic and catabolic activities, that is metabolic activities, the wastage is produced. This wastage should be removed. When it is not removed, it causes harm to the organism. So it should be removed. It should be removed by excretion. So here, in generally, what are the wastes are produced in the anabolic and catabolic activities? Now we will see the wastes are nitrogenous waste. Nitrogenous wastes are ammonia, urea, uric acid, bile pigments, excess water. They should be removed. When these are not removed, it is accumulated in the cell as well as in the blood, and also it leads to accumulation of all other organs and it leads to death. So it should be removed. So that's why excretion name is coined, comes from the Latin word. Ex means out, cretere means shift. So here the excess waste should be disposed of, it should be getting out, it should be thrown out. In the same way, cretere is shift. It can be shifted from one place to another place, from one form to another form. So normally from cell to blood, from blood to it will be thrown out. So what are the things we have seen? So where it is produced also we have seen. So how it should be removed? It should be removed by excretory organs. The excretory organ in human being is kidney, is the excretory organ. It can remove the waste. Now we will see the sample report of blood and urine samples. We will find the parameters. What are the normal parameters present in the blood and urine?
When we observe the blood and urine report of a person, we can find the components present in the blood and urine. In blood, glucose, sodium, potassium, chloride, urea, creatinine, uric acid, total cholesterol, triglyceride, calcium, phosphorus, bilirubin, total protein, albumin is present in blood. All the components of blood sample is also present in urine sample except cholesterol, triglycerides, bilirubin and albumin. Here we can observe some of the components like creatinine, total cholesterol are exceeding the normal limits. We can say that the person is slightly excess fat, and also excess creatinine also indicates the malfunctioning of kidney. Now let us see excretory system in human beings. In human beings, excretion occurs mainly through urinary or excretory system. It consisting of a pair of kidneys, a pair of ureters, urinary bladder and urethra. In human beings, there is a pair of bean-shaped reddish-brown structures in the abdominal cavity attached to the dorsal body wall, one on either side of the backbone. Each kidney is convex on the outer side and concave on the inner side. The right kidney is placed slightly lower than the left kidney. Do you know the reason for arranging such a way? Can you think? Yes, the reason is due to the location of liver above the right of kidney. So the right kidney lies 1 to 2 centimeters lower than the left kidney. Let us observe LS of kidney. In kidney, it shows two distinct regions. Dark colored outer zone is called the cortex and pale inner zone called medulla. The inner side of each kidney has a fissure or hilus for entry of renal artery, exit of renal vein and ureter. Renal artery brings oxygenated blood loaded with waste products and renal vein carries deoxygenated blood, the waste products generated in various organs of the body are filtered and removed by kidney. Each kidney is made up of approximately more than 1 million microscopic and thin tubular functional units called nephrons or uriniferous tubules. In medullary region, we can find more than a million microscopic thin tubular structures called as nephrons. It is the structural and functional unit of the kidney where the actual filtration takes place. We will recall the today's class once again. The first one, due to metabolism, several harmful excretory products are formed and process of removing toxic waste from the body is called excretion. Second one, human excretory system comprising a pair of kidneys, a pair of ureters, urinary bladder and urethra. The third point is, each kidney is composed of approximately 1.3 to 1.8 millions of uriniferous tubules or nephrons, which are structural and functional units of kidney.